I still had a bunch of work up that you're not allowed to see. I was like, hold on a minute. You didn't see it there because I had to blend the render open with nothing on there, but. I haven't pasted it in my server yet. Because I'm lazy boy. Well, I've been working all day. Don't judge me. Today was very boring as well. I love my job, but there are some days, like all days, that you're never going to have a perfect job where I'm just asked to do things that I'm not comfortable with doing. Right now, I'm sort of animating something for some UI elements, and so 2D animation. I'm not a 2D artist. I'm trying. And I know it's all, but we need to be flexible. We're a small company. That's great and all. But the people who say that are the people not being flexible. You know what I mean? Like, that's not being rude to them. They don't do other jobs. When people, this is actually, I feel that's a very important subject. When people hear that you're an artist, they forget that that's such a broad area of stuff. And almost everybody specializes in certain areas. Just because you're an artist doesn't mean you can do everything. It's like saying, oh, I use PCs. Doesn't mean you can do everything on PC. Doesn't mean you can sit down and program or do art. If you say you're a chef, it doesn't mean you can cook everything, right? If you're a pastry chef, it means you specialize in making pastries, but it doesn't mean you can do all the other stuff. It's, yeah. And I just find it very, it's not stressful. It's just, yeah. Like I said, the people who tend to ask to say that you need to be flexible are the people who aren't flexible. Like I've heard people say it who can't even remotely use a PC, like they have trouble using PCs and can't fix it. That's no fault of their own. They just didn't take the time to learn how to repair PCs if there's something wrong. Which is fine, but that's where the difference is. You know, they want me to go learn. Ooh. They expect me and other people in my company to. Or some people in my company saying it, to learn all these things when they didn't even take the time to learn how to use a PC. You know what I mean? Like, it's hypocrisy, maybe? Like, it's a balance. I'm not mad at them or anything. It's just a lot of hard work. I just want to sit there all day, every day, and do 3D modeling. Get given concept every day. Steve, make this a 3D model. Sweet, I'm on it. That's the dream. I'd love to do that. But that's not what I do at the moment. That's going to be really laggy for you guys, I just remembered. Is that laggy? Yeah, that's a... not as laggy as it usually is, though. So again, the light changes when I do that. Oh wow, that is a little laggy. So today I actually want to import or get like the building modeled to have all the other rooms. The only problem is I've not made it so the have I got roofs on it? Wow, I'm a little laggy. No, how are the roofs done? I know I made it, but. Oh, right. I usually have it at 50% so we don't lag. There you go. So they're to block out light, but how are the roofs actually done? Right, they're just... yeah, because you get light leak through. Even in UE5, you get light leaking through. Through. And then when you get the ceiling back on. Okay. So I wonder if I should build it up into separate pieces then. Because I could do the rest of the downstairs, because all I need to do is make a wall here. Make a wall here, make some walls here for the other room, and then make a wall here for the garage or the garage, as they say across the pond. Sorry, I got my exercise gear right here. I'm becoming swole. Trying to relax. I've almost finished reading The Walking Dead. That was very fun. Honestly, I'd say I've not read too many books right now, so I would say I was in my top 10, but I've probably not even read 10 different series at the moment. But it was really good. Walking Dead was actually a really nice read. I got two more books left. Yep. I got the hardbacks. I mean, if it's got pictures in it, it's always easier to read. I have trouble reading. I always have. Sometimes with things that are like close enough together, I keep just rereading the same line and stuff. I'm like, okay, wait, why is my little dancing? Oh, she's back. You stopped dancing for a minute. So we need. God, I got so many Blender files. Let's go into my hard drive and find it. All right, so front of the house. Wait, what's that? Has it got a roof on it from here? It does. Okay. See, it looks really cool in Blender. I love things looking untextured. Like, it just gives a really nice effect. I should have continued modeling in here, really, because I started modeling in a different. I started like I modeled a couple of things like Bart's skateboard and stuff in a different thing, but it's nice in here. I was actually thinking. Call me crazy, but I was actually thinking I really want to make the outside as well. But if I want to make any outside, it means I've got to make Ned Flanders' building and whoever's his neighbor on this side. And I, because I wanted to make the tree house, I thought that'd be really cool. But then I got to make the outside look good. So it's a little up in the air right now. I'm not sure how I want to do that. Because I'd have to raise all the walls up on the outside. Honestly, I wish I could just take a week. Problem is, if I took a week off to do this, would I have the motivation to do it? You know what I mean? Yeah, look, I just raised that up and we got a second story. Wait, what's happening there? Wait, what? Oh. Yeah, we got a second story, right? And then we start modeling the windows up here and stuff. Or we'd have to model all the window frames outside. But I do think it's possible. Because there's loads of reference to the Simpsons house. Simpsons house. Like, that's a pretty good one to work from. Pull that up. I'd have to make nicer roofy bit there. Because right now it's just like this. So I'll just have to make that curved bit at top and that should look fine. Oh, what the heck? I'd probably pick the orange over the the pink, purple. God, the modeling the car would be awesome too. The tree in the background, and then I'd have to model all of that house. It'd be a really fun project, but I'm just wondering if I have the time to do it. Like, I sit here just talking and not getting any work done because I've just worked all day. I was lazy this week. I would not like to admit that to my boss, and I did get work done, but I just didn't have a creative drive this week, which was a shame. Can't be creative every week, guys. You shouldn't feel guilty about that. It just happens. Why have I got this floating in the air? So preferably, I need to texture these better. I don't mind the shape of them. I think the shape of them works pretty well. But if we look at how they're textured in engine, they're not brilliant. I just quickly threw on a texture and hope for the best. So I'd like to actually make that look a bit better at some point. But the pillow's model looks good. We've got some high poly on it. You can see those creases and stuff. But the pillow itself, the textures don't look very good. Oh yeah, that lag for you guys. Anyways. Let's be chill today. And let's just start modeling. If I can grab the wall. Thank you. Start modeling. Oh, wait. So this is the... Oh, okay. Okay, it's fine. So I made it a tiny bit thinner. I can't remember why. There was a reason. But I basically just need to do this. I actually did this last week, didn't I? And then I didn't save it because I didn't want it. The question is this the most up-to-date version? If I select this wall, has it been unwrapped? It has. Okay. Wow, look how tightly packed that is. They all share just the tiling texture, so it doesn't matter too much. I don't know what's happening here, though. This is just basically if I bake it, which I won't be doing anyway. We're using lumen, so I actually don't need to worry about baking. I know you can still bake in lumen, but I'd like to do a fully dynamic scene using the new lumen lighting. Do this. So yeah, after this stream, I'm probably going to go and read. I know, crazy, right? So this, I just need to cut across. But the problem is, maybe I won't cut across fully. I'll do this, so we get the door location. And then this, so that way when I go to edit it, and when I want to get the door, I just have to delete that part like this. Whoops. Like this, and boom, we have that door entrance. We can get rid of you, or at least put you over here. See that? And then I just need to fill in all the bits. Like that. Thick walls, but I guess that's not too far-fetched. Oh, I'll have to delete the roofing bits as well. So I'll have to basically go like this. And like that. Boom, we got the top bits deleted. Cool. Was that the heights of the doors, though? Because I'd like to keep that relatively the same. That was very loud. Stop motion, Frasier. Thank you for subscribing/following. I hope you're enjoying the stream. If you didn't get to see what the scene looked like, voila. Like I said, I do want to make this an entire scene. My original thought was just make the living room look good in UE5. And I was like, I added some cans. I had skateboard. I added the record player, which isn't the best quality, I'll admit. It's not too detailed, but if I'm going for the entire house, I think I have to be a bit conservative for the time I spend. So yeah, I really, really would like to do the whole thing. He's basically, all right. Oh, that looks cool. Thank you, Stop Motion Frasier. If you haven't seen my work before, you can check the description. There should be an ArtStation link for you to have a quick gander. That's a word I don't use very often, but it's a very good English word. I think that's an English word. I'm going to get told by an American that, no, we use that word all the time. I have no idea. They might use that word all the time. All right, I see. See this, and snap it to there. Do this, and snap that to there. Cool. And then I need to basically delete you. My claim to fame on this scene was that it only took me 3 days from start to finish. But I can't say that anymore, because every weekend now I'm spending a couple hours on it. Which, I actually had someone say this recently. Was it, no, not someone say, I read a review on a game, and someone said, I think you are very underrated. Thanks, man. That's so nice of you to say. Yeah, I was, somebody what was it, a game. I've lost my train of thought. What was I going to say? I can't remember. My brain's a little fried today, I'll admit. Cool. So we'll get those in. Get those in. Get those in. What do you do, Stop Motion Frasier? I have a feeling you might say you make stop motion animations. I feel like I said that wrong, but I could be wrong. So now that's the gap for the door, correct? Yeah, so if we delete UUU. Oh, that's a good... Yeah, sometimes. Oh, okay. I was always super interested in stop motion when I was a kid. Just thought it was really cool. I still think it's really cool. Yeah, that's not really changed. It's an animation style, should call it, that I've always thought was just fascinating. Click this so we can actually see the points. There you go. If I actually had like a setup, I growing up, I never really had I would have never had an area to do this. And even when I've gotten older, I still don't have, until I actually rent a large house, not even large, I just always want to do stop motion, because stop motion is really, really fun. Just like place something, slightly move it, picture, slightly move it again, picture, slightly move it again. And you just get this fluid looking animation. And all it is you moving like a toy. Someone actually I was watching YouTube at the moment who makes little animations. He's let's go find him. It's hard to because I don't have the equipment. Yeah, that's also a thing as well. As a thing with anything, like even with me with the PC making 3D, like my desk's a little bit of a mess, but I'll show you guys anyway. I'll show you at the moment. We sometimes get people in the stream, but it's, sometimes just don't really get anyone. Oh, wow, I need it a bit more zoomed out. It's like, if we just look at like what I got set up here, 3 separate monitors. I got a 2K monitor, graphics tablet monitor. I've got like drawing pens, well, sculpting pens. Oops. Like it comes to a lot of money, but my computer has always earned me money because I've done freelance stuff and whatnot, and now I'm obviously doing a career out of it. I work as a 3D artist at a company, so I've always felt like that money wasn't wasted because it's going towards essentially getting more money. And even if it's not, right, it was always my hobby too, to do 3D art or to play video games, which both are on the PC. So I've never considered it a waste of money anyway, but it doesn't make it any better when trying to justify spending the money at the end of the day. Because that's always hard to throw money at something. So is this actually the size of the doors? I know it looks terrible, but if I do this, it's not. Is it where the windows start? Oh, it's where the windows start. Right, okay. Oh, wait. I just deleted faces only, didn't I? What's this? Oh, it's the other side. So have I left the underneath bits as well? I have. They've got to make sure to delete those too, so. It's funny because I've always had a passion for making things. I've discussed this loads on my stream. I've always had a passion for making things. However, I've always struggle with being creative. It's not something that ever really came that naturally to me. So I basically use what I know from a technical standpoint, and I make things using that knowledge rather than using artistic ability. And I'd like to think it's worked out for me at this point, but so if we want to make it curved or like this to match all the other ones, just need to do that. But that's not going to be the right height, if I'm correct. If I grab this quick, I'll just align that with you. It's supposed to be that high. Okay, so we'll grab this and I'll make it to the height of that. And then if we do this, got to have some tall doorways. Is that right? I kind of don't mind making that a shorter door. I could always change it later if I don't like it. There you go. So now we've got a door leading over here. I should really finish off from a top-down position. I think one of the biggest things about art that worries a lot of people is when you start making something, it can look garbage. And a really good example of this, because I was judging myself so much when drawing the eye for my character. I'll show you my character. I'm not a character artist, but I do want to make this character. I do want to get him finished. Maybe I'll do some more of them tomorrow. It's because I got stuck. I couldn't figure out how to do his ear hair, or his tail hair. But like, I was really judgmental on myself during the stream when it loads, when doing his eyes. But his eyes turned out fine. They pretty much turned out exactly how I wanted them. But if you look when I started drawing it, so this one, I assume. I'll mute it so you don't have to hear me talking again. So I was trying to figure out how to do, hey, Letterborn. See, I streamed early today and you're actually here. You said I streamed too late, so I was trying to do eyelids and I was looking at somebody else's I looked at someone else's video, but did not help too much on mine. I had to kind of like wing it anyway. It was, I meant to say I tried to model, but when I showcase it, people don't like it and it makes me feel like it's very bad. I for a very long time, so I'll show you this quickly. Oh, look at that. Why am I so big? Am I drawing the eye here? So yeah, there you go. Watch. When I start drawing the eye at the start, I'm telling myself it's garbage. It doesn't look very good. And then as I'm like going along, I'm following like this kind of step-by-step thing, but my eye needed to be different. So I was kind of using it as a guide. And I was going along, I was like, this still looks garbage, this still looks garbage. And then as I started adding more and more detail to it, I was like, oh, it actually doesn't look too bad now. And that's a really big thing, is like, there's a big difference between the foundation stage of your work and the end stage of your work. And it can feel really bad when you're just at that like foundation stage, but it's the foundation stage is as important as those end detail stages. Done with my degree, I hope I can put a lot of effort into personal projects as soon as I feel better. I'd love to see them. Well, especially if it's art, but I'm pretty sure you said you want to get into programming, if I'm correct. But yeah, because like if we look at the start of this, look, that looks garbage. That doesn't look like anything good. And then at the end, and when we add all the detailing in, it actually, well, that's a bit close. Oh my God. It actually doesn't look too bad. And when I actually apply it to its character, there's two Steves. There is two Steves, yes. That's not the character. When I apply it to the character, it actually, you know, worked. But yeah, like going off the topic you just said, stop motion Frasier. It's a long road to getting good at any field you want to be good in. I still don't consider myself that good. A lot of people these days praise me a lot more than I used to. When I was getting into doing 3D and stuff, and I was trying really, really hard, all I got was pushback from people. All I got told was I wasn't good enough, my art wasn't good enough. You know, it doesn't look real. Like, I'll show you an example of like one of the first things I made in third, or one of the last things I made in third year of university. Ideally, combining the two, art and programming, but right now I thought grid characters because your stream. Love the eyes, by the way. Thank you. But yeah, it's like this. So people love this. This is the first thing I ever out put out there that people loved. And the funny thing is this scene isn't very good. If you actually start looking at the assets and stuff, I mean, if you look at that, it doesn't look real or anything. It doesn't look very realistic. But when I used to make stuff for this, I used to get pushed back. I used to get told if my work wasn't good enough. And people would never give very constructive criticism. It would just be stuff like, oh, like I just said, doesn't look realistic enough. What does it? What do you think I could do to improve it? Just doesn't look right. That doesn't help me. Like, tell me what I can do. Tell me what I can do to fix it. Tell me what I can do to make it look more realistic. And sometimes it comes down to just time. How much time you can invest into it. And time is very, very important with work. Because if you look at most of my assets, I've said this many times, you guys have watched me 3D model for years, and I do not spend more than 3 hours on most of my assets. There are some exceptions, and here's where the exceptions come in. Reminds me of a cooking simulator art-wise, specifically the pizza one. Always makes me hungry. Yeah, so these are assets where I took more than 3 hours. But let's look at some assets. Time and energy. You ever see Shawshank Redemption when they talk about... how was it? Pressure and time. But anyway, so... I'll show you some assets that took 3 hours each. Because like I said, I usually spend 3 hours or less. And if we get to the Simpsons scene... everything in here, every asset in here took 30 minutes or less, minus probably these guys that I did recently and the skateboard and stuff. The couch, all of this, because I only had 3 days to do it in, so I had to rush everything. So this definitely, this TV, probably an hour, maybe an hour and a half. And if we look at my art station... so to anyone who hates me getting sidetracked, I like to talk about this stuff because I just think it's important for people to hear. I always want to encourage people to push their art and don't feel bad about their art and actually enjoy what they do. So I feel like when I start talking about this, these topics, I want to fully explain what I'm getting at. And right now, as I'm saying, I'm talking about, Freddie was just joined, I'm talking about how good things look depending on time. My hair is crazy. Because when someone compares your work, well, now it looks really neat. When someone compares your work with like, oh, look at this guy's, and they show it to you, and it literally says that guy took 6 months on it. You sit there and you're like, but I spent a week on my work. Like, it's not gonna look as good. Not only is this guy like AAA studio quality, he's like a senior, he took 6 months on it, so of course you can't compare me to this. You're very fast compared to me, or I'm very slow. I take days, my brain just stops every 30 minutes and it doesn't do anything for a while, and that leaves so much stuff. A lot of people are like that. My biggest asset is probably my speed. There's some people who are really, really fast will tell me I'm slow, but when my boss asks me to make something, I might not make it to a really, really, really good quality, but I make it good enough, and I make it in a very decent amount of time, usually. I get my weeks where I'm slow. This week, I've not been artistically there at all. Yeah, so that's what I was doing. Let's look at some assets. There you go. Some assets that I spent 3 hours or less on. And you know this, because you can literally watch my time lapses of me making most of these. Everything here, 3 hours or less. And I made high polys for all of these. I'm pretty sure I made, I think it was this and this in one stream. It was a long stream, like a 4 or 5 hour, but all 3 hours or less. There might be one exception, which is maybe this, but I still think it took me 3 hours or less. Now, you know, they look all right. They work for what I wanted them to do. However, let's look at some assets that took me 15 hours or less. So I'm pretty sure this one only took me 3 hours or less as well, because I did this one during my stream when I was making that other scene. But this guy took me 5 to 6 hours, and I wish it was a 3D spin around. That's much better quality than a lot of my Starlight things. Then if we look at this guy probably took me 10 to 15 hours, and you could already see the quality just skyrocketing, getting so much better just because more time was dedicated. And I think today we're seeing people on YouTube, sometimes you see someone make something really cool in 10 minutes and it can really put you off. But if you want some solid art, it's going to take you some time. And I think that's really important to learn, because I hate spending a long time making things. When I was in uni, I was the same way. I want to get things done. I just want it done. I want to get really snappy with it. Another asset. This actually only took me a day to texture, but I think it took me a long time to model. I said day to texture. It took me one stream to texture. So this probably took me 2 hours to texture, and then maybe 10 hours to model, if not longer. But do you know... Oh, yeah, the game engine. Yeah. They've talked about it in chat before. What about it? I've never used it or really looked into it. Me talk about that just made 5 people leave, apparently. Yeah, it took me a whole 6 weeks internship to make a bridge and a fortress that was pre-made. Oh. I mean, like I said, it's... Obviously, when you're in a job... I need to stop saying the word, obviously. When you're in a job, it's going to be a concern how quickly you are. And it doesn't matter where you work, what you do. That's going to eventually be a concern from your employer, because they want as much bang for their buck. But with that said, it's also very important... So what doors are on here? Because these don't have doors. Neither does that one. But then these start having doors. I'm going to have to find reference, I think. Anyways, yeah, time is going to be something that employers are obviously going to want. They don't want time, you know what I mean? They want their money that they're spending to be spent efficiently. And as much as I want to be like, oh, the employers... being like wanting us to... Oh, that's a workbench. That window there. We'll just pull it all the way across for now. They have a bar? I thought he usually parks his car in there. I'm back. Hey. Wait, how much did you miss? Oh, wait. Then we need the garage door. I say for now, we just do this. And then I'll cut out a shape for that. It was non-profit, single guy with his project, and he didn't really care. There was no money pressure anyway. I just am disappointed with myself. Everyone gets faster over time. I looked into... How do you say it? Godot? Godot? No, it won't be Godot. Godot? Godot? Well, it was Godot. I merge distance here. We should just combine all those, right? Oh, you got the interior. Oh no. How did I only grab one edge of it? Whoops. Oh yeah. It looks like... God, my brain. It looks like I upcoming game engine broke. Oh, right. That's why he's just kicking enter. I mean, that confused me for a second. Jesus. Why did that not select all of it? Did I not do that last time? So now, if I set that and go merge distance, would I not just... I swear it usually tells me that I have done that. And then if I come up to here and delete that, then delete that, we'll delete all the interior ones like this, and that should... no. Let's delete this. Now that should be fine, right? Yeah. This. There you go. Boom. Lovely jubbly. So we're going to have to stretch over the floor and stuff. Am I using that floor? What is the floor? Oh, is it just the roof? Yeah. Oh, no, it's not. They're like separate pieces. Okay. So I'm going to have to make a bit for that as well. Look, would you say it's worth learning from scratch? Because I really want Unity for my project. It's about very realistic car driving physics. Physics are important, right? Wait. Would you say it's worth learning from scratch? Because I really want Unity for my project. I'd say not over just using Unity, right? It looks like an easy game. Make a PC, I will download and tell you about it in a second. Anyways, what I need to learn is to manage my energy first. Okay. And then not get distracted, and then we can work on the speed. Yeah, I mean, it's all about development. I'm a fast learner on software, slow learner on pretty much everything else. So my strongest suits were getting a new piece of software, learning how it worked, and then it was slow after that point for me, and it always has been. I've been modeling since I was 13 years old, and I still struggle with some of the most basic shapes after 14 years of trying to 3D model. Admittedly, I wasn't that into it when I was younger. Oh, well, no. That's not good. Is that actually what it looks like in the model? Where is that? That is... what is, what's going on there? Oh my god, what is going on there? Yeah, at the end of the day, it's all about finding your strengths and your weaknesses, finding what you're good at, finding what you're bad at, and then working on the... I really like working on the thing... we all like working on the things we're good at. I hate shedding issues like that. Oh no, I definitely knew that was the mess. I knew I'd messed up in some way. Then I should be able to just do that. There you go. Can't even get UE5 because my freaking laptop won't let me. Ah. Oh no, like, oh no. Oh, look, it's UE5. Whoa. I used to 3D model on a laptop and everything. One thing that annoys me at the moment, and it doesn't seem to bother my boss, is everyone we seem to want to hire, and even people who are in the company at the moment, just all seem to use laptops. Not the programmers, not the artists, but we've hired artists who use who just use the laptop and stuff. And I'm like, please, if we hire someone, make sure they have a workstation. I know that's kind of mean, because it's like, oh, but you're throwing away anyone who... I mean, if they're really good, hire them even if they use a laptop. But if they're fairly mediocre and require a lot of training, I'd rather we just hire someone with a PC or a workstation, like a desktop, because it's just so much better to work on. It's really hard. I couldn't do it. If you said, Steve, be a good artist and do it on a laptop, I'd be like, I'd be struggling. Unless my company is fine supplying a computer, obviously. Like, I didn't, but when I try to get UE5, it crashes. That's weird. I didn't. I could say I ran UE5 on a laptop a while ago, but I didn't. I ran ray tracing on UE4. Whoops. It's going to be a short stream today, by the way, guys. I want to do a couple of things. I've got an actual hospital appointment tomorrow. I'm getting some form of x-ray, which is going to be very exciting. No, nothing's wrong that I'm aware of. I'm getting it because I've been experiencing some pains, and I want to see if they're being caused by anything. My doctor seems pretty confident they're not going to find anything and says I'm completely fine. So I should be fine. Oh, so if I don't stream tomorrow, it's because I am still at the hospital. I didn't even think about like you getting in the way of streaming. Exciting. I shouldn't have even acknowledged that joke. I wish my laptop would work. I love my PC, but it means if not at home, no modeling and being in new environments always makes me want to model. Hey, Brittany King. Oh, wow. What an awesome last name. God, my last name's Christopher. You know how annoying it is to have my last name is Christopher. Like, all I ever got in school and stuff was, oh, what's your last name? Like, what's your last name? Christopher. And they would move their pen over, write Christopher in the first name or the forename section, and go, okay, what's your last name? My last name is Christopher. My first name is Stephen. Oh. And they'd be like, and writing my first name in the for my actual first name. How's it going, Brittany? So, door here. We're making the Simpsons. The Simpsons. Wait, so where's the door? Oh, the door's here. And then it's just. Oh, is that the back door? They have two back doors? Okay. Huh. Have you ever been in the house with two back doors and one front door? Because if so, I mean, that's either a very good house or just terrible security. Good, love your ship project turned out. How? Sorry, I was gonna say that doesn't make sense. I'll show you how. There's actually a bit more done on it. I need to finish it. I don't know why I keep putting it off. You know, like when there's just like a little bit to do on something and you just can't be bothered. Because I want to spend the weekend doing the Simpsons scene now because I've started a new thing. So I don't want to do it on stream. I didn't want to anyway because it's like small bits I'm gonna have to watch tutorials on. But I've put it into UE5 now, which I'm pretty sure is not what I rendered it on my art station. I'm modeling hard edge stuff. I always have this urge to make edges disappear as quickly as possible as soon as I don't need them anymore. Getting rid of edge loops is what you mean. Getting rid of edge loops is a really good thing. Like if we had, let's go to Blender. Let's start a new project quick because I actually want to show you this. It's really important. If you look at stuff like Half-Life and look at their 3D models, they do this really well. So if we get like our cube, I'm not going to delete it. If we get our cube, right? And we, I don't know, we go like this. We go like, we'll just do one lot. We'll do this. We'll do this, right? We pull this out. This is already more or less optimized because what we can do now. Last thing, you start doing this, especially because it's a flat surface, and you could start, you know, optimizing it. I assume this is kind of what you meant, right? Oh no! How did I manage that much last? Wait. Oh, other way around. What am I doing? There you go. I love doing that. You just spend all the time. Now, this is not a bad thing. My only concern when doing this is one, I'm too lazy to do it because I don't care about it being clean. Because this is more or less cleaner geometry. So the drawbacks from this. So I'm going to show Brittany the scene in a minute as well. Drawbacks to this is. Oh, actually, I'll say the positives. You're saving on poly count. It may even be easier to UV map. And in general, it's just going to be better for your performance, right? And that's pretty good. Oh, this other side. Now, I could have modeled it that way, I know. If we were to model it that way, it would have just gone something like this. So take that, do this, do this, do this. And we did this, right? All you'd have to do instead is grab the face, pull it in, grab to the right size, pull it out. Which will even be more optimized, because obviously the back, we could have done that as well. But you don't always get that choice when 3D modeling. You don't always have the choice to do it the most optimized way when doing the original model. Now, the drawbacks from this... Let's replace, there are some shading issues I have noticed. Oh, what, on this so far? Or do you mean in general? The drawback is if I wanted to add another bit, right? I've only got control over this now. So if I was like, oh, I want to add like a cube coming out this area here. I want to be flat along here. I've got all of this weird geometry, which I'd have to fix anyway, right? And sometimes you can't even do edge loops because the way you've optimized it won't allow it anymore. Whereas if we just had our basic shape and we had that stuff before, not that way. Cool. I wouldn't need to optimize it, right? If I was like, oh, I want a cube that's up here, we'll just add two of those in, move that over, and boom, we've got that in, right? It's just much easier to work with. Yes, you get a more complex shape that you should optimize, but yeah. Not on this, but in general, if you don't have enough edge loops. Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah. Especially if you like to smooth it. Oh wow, that's interesting. Bevel. Boom. Well, making high mesh and then retopologizing. Yeah. Anyways, eager Brittany. Let's have a look at my boat. That's not my boat scene. At my boat scene. Did I call it the environment boat? Boat. There you go. So yeah, I've converted it all over to UE5. So the lighting's somewhat the same, except it's dynamic. And in my opinion, it looks better. The only problem is Lumen. Oh, wait, do not show you it in full screen because it will lag out the stream. Directional light. So I'm pretty sure if we turn one off and on. Oh, no, that's the right way. You get all this like nice bouncing light here. If you compare it to the old one. So there's my boat. I have an angle down there. So here, if we compare that. Where the hell did it go? Yeah. Compare that. I kind of want to do this. It's going to be a little... Oh, this isn't laggy. What? Why is this scene not laggy, but the Simpsons one is? Is it because I'm on a lower setting? 100? That's fine. Hold on a minute. Is Simpsons still laggy then or not? Why is Simpsons laggy? There's less in here. Whatever. So let's actually try to get the angles lined up. Oh no, it's the website, isn't it? It's a little bit off. Like here, right? Yeah. So you see that, which, you know, I don't think looks bad, but you haven't got any of the light sort of giving a nice bounce off of all this wood, which will give them sort of an orange glow on everything else, which it does in Lumen, and it gives all this. That's weird. Wait, which part? Yeah, it gives this really nice bounce lighting, and it's the same with all the scenes. You get all this. Oh, would you talk about the Simpsons not being laggy? No, Simpsons being laggy and this one not being laggy. Yeah, it is weird. My foot's stuck in a wire. But the way, look at here, look at this. Look at the way that the lighting bounces and stuff. The lag, yeah, sorry. I talk so much and change thoughts all the time, I get a little lost. And we've got the whole exterior lit up. Got this room that looks really nice with the lighting. I added these in. These are like essentially decals. Oh god. If I can grab it. Is that it? No, that's not it. Is that it? There you go. Have they changed the symbol for decals? Oh, they have. What the heck? Yeah, so look, you got this like really sort of 3D effect. And I also, another improvement I've made for UE5 is I've made the wood look a lot more 3D, which is technically still 2D. It's just using parallax mapping. But yeah, the lighting's a bit different now, but I like it. Because like, she looks really nice now. I need to still fix her. So there's her I need to fix. I need to actually get some eyelashes in, then I need to properly rig her so her hair doesn't go funny. Looks amazing in Lumen. It's so nice in Lumen. It's annoying because Lumen keeps like changing the way it looks. Like if I simulate. Okay, it doesn't look too bad, I don't think, when you simulate. You get some changes. You see that? You got like that shadow here. And the shadow's not here now. I don't even know where that shadow's coming from. But yeah, a good example of Lumen being weird. What games do you play? I play a bit of everything. My favorite games, despite playing them not very much, are platformers. And I think that's because a good platformer, like a really good one, comes around in a blue moon. I like how it says I've got zero viewers, even though three of you are talking right now. You better have a character controller and some awesome wooden footsteps. That'd be cool. Oh, actually making a walk around. And I want to actually do an animation. God, I hate working full time. I don't, but man, if I had the time. What was I saying? I lost train of thought. I was saying about the lighting. So if you look at like the lighting in in the Simpsons scene, which is laggy, so I won't full screen it. Watch what happens when I simulate. Oh, platformers, that's what I was talking about. I'll talk about that in a second. When I simulate, look how much brighter it gets. Then when I stop simulating, boom. Why is the lighting changing? It was doing it in my other project too, but somehow that fixed itself. Yeah, I don't know where the lighting changes when I simulate, because my preview should look exactly the same as the simulator. There's no blueprints that turn on a light source when it plays. I don't know what's doing it. It's like there's less bounces or something when... No, more bounces when simulating versus preview or editor, should I say. And I don't know what's causing it. Anyways, yeah, platformers. I think platformers are so few and far between. Like really good ones that I don't play them very much. But when I get my hands on a good platformer, like A Hat in Time, Super Meat Boy, Crash Bandicoot, Ratchet and Clank, Jak and Daxter. Mario is really good, but I barely played Mario games. Not because they're bad, because I just didn't really own any. Does she keep slowing down on the bottom left of my screen? I think she does. What some other ones can figure top of my head? I never played Banjo-Kazooie very much. Yeah, got Sly Cooper, but they're all so good. They're all such good games. 2D, 3D, I don't care. I love platformers. But my main game I probably play, oh my god, it's just a bit of everything. Do you have manual exposition here? As an exposure? Is that what you mean? Like, does it change when I go outside? Because I've got mine set to a... It does change a little bit, actually, as you can see. Yeah, sorry. To be fair, that might also be a correct way of saying it. I've changed it a bit. Exposure. Let's have a look. Oh my god, I can't spell. So I've got the compensation up a little bit. And I've turned it to 0.03 and 0.03. I can't tell if I like the way it's lit up, though. Because we get these really dark areas, like down here, the bottom left. Am I still laggy? Yeah. And it's like here. Look at this. Look how dark it is in here. Whereas, like, you'd get some light bouncing in there. So I'm still a little bit wary on how I want to do the lighting. But I was thinking earlier today, if I'm going to be expanding the scene to conclude all the rooms and even possibly do an exterior at some point, I should not worry about the lighting until we're at a stage I will consider final. So we'll just mess with what we got for now. If we like it for now, we'll keep it, and then we'll change it later to be better if we want to change it. It's like this scene. When I was in this scene, I was messing around with the lighting for ages, and I think I'm finally at a point where I like the lighting. I think outside it still kind of looks meh. I don't know why. Is it the skylight, maybe? I don't know if it's too bright, too foggy. There's something about the outside lighting that I'm not too comfortable with. Oh, that definitely changed. That looks better. Because you would get all this blue appearing. Did that change the interior lighting doing that? Man, this looks good. Oh, and I need to do the rug. I need to make the rug look good. I kind of want to make the rug do kind of similar to what the Simpsons is doing with a parallax mapping. Where you get this, like, fluffiness on it. But I need to find patterns and stuff I want to use. So, yeah, rug, character. I did say something else, I believe. And the globe. I need to paint something for the globe to throw on there. I don't know what yet. I could make my own little world. Could get a world map, kind of draw over some stuff, not make it actually look like our world, and then paint something. Because it just needs to look like something, you know? It doesn't even need to look good. It just needs to have something there. Maybe some markers on it, because obviously it's a globe, and they probably will have some markers on it. I got 4 cups on my desk. And a bottle. Oh no, I got another cup here. There we go. I'll take those downstairs after the stream. Yeah, so let's get back to the actual building. So, is this just the grass outside? Let's put it all the way across then, if that's the case. So, I need to get these aligned with the rooms. Have you ever thought about giving the ship movement? Probably not when you're inside it, but would cause dizziness. But if you had a camera panning around it front side, and it would move a little. Yeah, but I think the better way to do that would be make the rest of the world move. Kind of like how they did it in Uncharted 3. Retrain sequence behind the scenes. I think it was Uncharted 3 that did it. Uncharted 3. Lots of games have done this before. This is just an example. Oh, Uncharted 3 wasn't an example of it. What is it? Hold on a minute. That sounds great. Yeah. I don't think this is actually doing it in Uncharted 3. But loads of games have done it where you move everything around you. Okay, so the train does move in Uncharted 3. I was wrong. But yeah, you move everything around you to simulate everything, the actual ship moving, and then we can have camera shake and stuff to give the illusion of more movement. I think that would be a better way to do it, because there's so many assets and stuff in the ship that I don't know how well they'd move. And Lumen, it'd be better, because obviously it's all dynamically lit, but I'm still a bit worried about how it would work. Let's close that. No. I wonder if I could change anything I want to keep. Let's come back into here. It's like the walls. Come up here. Let's finish up. What's happening here? Oh, wait, what? Excuse me. Oh my god. Terrible of me. Very impolite. Okay, so I need this. I'm hoping to finish The Walking Dead either tonight or tomorrow. I'm gonna need my computer to read the last book though, because I don't own the 16th book. So if anyone wants to donate a book, then that's the hole downstairs, right? Let's hide that. Because I'd like to, it'd also be fun to model all the stuff in here, you know what I mean? Like I've already done. and then we just start modeling it for all the rooms. I think that'd be really fun. Yeah, so we've got the doorway here now, and then oh, this one isn't done. Nope. For some reason, there's still things in Blender that I will never get used to. And one of them is the difference between these two buttons. This one makes it so you don't see any of the actual development stuff, right? So you can see like that. I don't know what it's called. Show overlays, there you go. And this one makes it transparent, essentially, so you can select things behind it. You get X-ray. But I always click the wrong one because it's a square with a square to the side of it. Then it's a circle with a circle to the side of it. So for some reason, I never seem to remember which is which. I always click the wrong one. Cool, that looks good. Now, I need some reference here, right? If we go Simpsons Garage... That's not the gap. What the heck is this? That's the basement, right? Yeah, basement. So it is a square door, and it is got has got a skirting board. Okay. Is there no? Oh my god. That's all that's in there in this picture. So it's got a workbench with a door. A square door. Okay, that's good enough information already, because it means I can keep the door square and I don't have to make it one of these doors. How did I? Oh, I just filled in a thingy here. Should I do that? Do this basically, like this. Select the edges and make it one big N-gon like that. That's probably better, to be fair. Probably gets rid of unnecessary vertices doing that. I'm an N-gon lover now. I honestly don't think they're as bad as I used to make out. I hate when I confuse the tab key and the one above, right? Which for my me isolation is like right isolation selection, yeah. And when I expect to go into edit mode, I hate it when I suddenly wait. Does that? Oh, okay. You've changed it to do that, right? Is that in another software? Is that in Blender? Yeah, one thing I always do in Blender as well, despite using it for like 2 years now, is when you export FBX, selected objects, I still don't select it. It still doesn't cross my mind to do that tick box when I export something, and I don't know why. It's infuriating, believe me. So have I got a skirting board? I do. Okay. What's the kitchen like? Kitchen. I mean, I could just import it like this so we get all the parts in. Let's do the floors as well. I think N-gons are fine when they're on complete flat surface, but I have found it can make the texture UVs look yeah. If it's on flat surfaces, they're definitely all right. I was very against them growing up. I was very against them for a long time, and I still am for certain reasons, because if you're trying to do something in Substance or ZBrush, I think it's Substance, it might just be ZBrush, ZBrush won't even let you import something with N-gons. It throws a hissy fit, at least for me. I've always had trouble. And if you have the same keyboard or not. Oh, I got a button above tab, but my tab, the button above tab does this. You did say above tab, right? If you use the tab key and the one above, yeah. I'm very congested. That's the main thing that I think is wrong with me at the moment. I'm like super, I got a lot of mucus. A bit too much information, but I got a lot of mucus playing on the back of my throat. And I don't know why. that? Oh, that was a picture of my stream. I saw like my weapons when I opened up my phone. It has the Celsius and law thingies on it. The what? I don't have a Celsius sign. Well, then my 4 key looks like it's coming up above the other keys for some reason. I should probably UV map these walls as well while I'm here. How did I do it last time? Did I just... Because if you look at my UVs, everything's just kind of overlapped. Which is fine. That's actually not an issue at all. There's no seam on them. Oh, you know what? I probably just did this. I went smart project. Definitely. Then I probably did a pack. Oh, no, I didn't even use two packs. So I didn't use texture at manganese. So this might mess things up. We'll have a look. I'll go export FBX. I'm just going to... let's just assets. Walls. SM underscore wall. It's weird S thing that is used for paragraphs. I don't even know. I am noticing my 4 key is slightly above the other keys and it's bugging me. Why is the 4 key so high? Why can't I get it any lower? Oh, that's better. SM underscore walls will write, actually. Clarifies all of them. Grab this. I like how, no matter what, when I start a project, I always start expanding it to unrealistic standards. Now I'm obsessed with... I want to make the entire building. I only wanted to do the living room. And now I'm just like, everything. Wait, selected objects. I'm confused now. Oh, man. Oh, bugger. I did it again. I've had like a phlegmy throat for like 3 months. It's horrible. I don't know what's going on. I ended up ZBrush by accident. If you needed it, but it's always bugs me when I see it unselected. Oh, right, right. Oh, right. I did need it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sorry. That's what I was about to say. I've forgotten. I've got to click out selected object again because I always forget. Look, look how long it's taken. Oh, did I actually cancel it? Oh, nice. I just said that sign. I always forget. It doesn't cross my mind because in it might be because in Maya you just click file export selected. I don't know why it's not on by default in Blender. I know you do. It should be on by default. Oh, where is it? Alright, so what's this called? Is this just got a funny name? It does. So let's place this for now. Did that work? It didn't look like it did anything. Oh, yep. What is it? It gets a lot lighter for some reason. Only out there, though. Wait, hold on a minute. Okay. Okay. So that still looks normal. This hasn't got the right textures on it. That's fine. It's only got one texture. We'll change that at some point. This is getting through the wall now, so we'll... Why did I make the fence one object? What's wrong with me? Delete the fence. We can get the new fence at some point. Can't see it there now, though. But that's fine. We'll get that in at some other point. Okay. So, yeah, so we need all the floors in out here. We need the ceilings in, which is why I should be getting so light in here, because all the light come from here. That's fine. Oh, yeah, that's fine. That's fine. So... We'll come to here, and as I was doing, I'll quickly get all the floors done. We want a wireframe, and we want to go to layout, grab you, and start making it so it sticks to the walls. Oh, wait, there's another door there? Did I not model that, or did I? Did I not model that? Oh, I did. I just didn't make the door. Because that's the basement. Ooh, modeling the basement would be interesting. God, there's so... Like, it's so weird how modeling one house... Wait, how does this work? Oh, it's got a wall there. Does it? It doesn't have a wall there in here. Oh, no. I'd like to make the basement. Because the basement's kind of iconic, but... The basement changes all the time, actually. I say it's iconic. It never stays consistent. Yeah, even in this design, they've got... Wait, what's the first floor? Yeah, this is the first floor. Yeah. Even in this design, they've got a wall here for it. So we'll make a wall there. That's fine. That's fine, I guess. Yeah, this will be another project that I... and I know I said it's about more projects, but this will be another project where I care more about finishing it than I do having it, like, insane quality. I think the quality right now is pretty good in the main room, and I'd like to keep it that good if I can. If I can't, due to time constraints, that's how it's just got to be. Especially considering I really can't find the time to do it these days. I recently discovered it's fun watching shows I have already seen. During modeling, would probably be fun and useful to watch The Simpsons during this. Oh, 100%. I did that when I made the Friends environment. I did that, like Monica's apartment from the Friends that I showed you earlier. I was watching Friends while doing it. It was great. It was because my teacher let me watch it in class, from what I remember. I'm pretty sure he did, because it was technically research. What brilliant research! I get to watch. Like one of my favorite shows. Is Friends one of my favorite shows, or is it just something that's very easy to watch and enjoy? I'd say it's one of my favorite shows. I don't want to put the show down. I enjoyed it. All right, now we need to. Can I select it? Oh, hi, image. Let's say some gangsters dissing your fly girl. Just give him one of these. I know so many quotes from that show. I love The Simpsons. Banger of a show. Oh, it does do it from there. Okay, it's fine. Okay. Now, the floors. So this actually has to be not square, but it's fine. So just do this. This is this the best way to make this? I have no idea. Is that how I'm going to make it? 100%. I like cover sitcoms, but this one never clicked with me. It's only partly the laugh track, but mostly, I guess. It's not a laugh track, though. They do Friends in a with a live audience. Or do you just mean that in general? Like, having that, like, live audience laugh? Because, like, even laugh tracks have never bothered me personally, because I feel like some shows kind of need them. You can say, oh, but that means they're terrible comedy, but I don't see it that way. Certain things don't deliver properly with silence, because the laughing just bothers me. Yeah, I mean, I know it bothers a lot of people, but if you watch certain things, the laugh track is necessary, because it causes, like, space between the space. Well, it causes spacing between scenes and environment and dialects, scripts, between the characters. Like, it's like a break in a way, because it's a sitcom. You're supposed to relax when watching it, so it's like a short break for you. But I know a lot of people don't like them, so I'm not saying you. I'm not trying to convince you why you should like it. Very good. Now I'm going to make them all separate. Cool, so we should have this. And this. Oh, did I not make one in there? What? Did I delete it? I swear I just made one in there. Apparently not. You play Fortnite? No. I played it once upon a time, not very long. Honestly, shooting games bore the hell out of me. I think they're... I played them, don't get me wrong. I was playing Apex Legends with my mate for a while again, not long ago. But I get so bored of shooting games. It's crazy. I didn't separate that out, whoops. Shooting games are... I can't say they're one of my worst genres, because I've played them too much. But equally, I don't think they're that brilliant. Maybe that comes down to the similarities, because at the end of the day, it's hard to make shooting games different. All of them are point and shoot. I like fighting games. Ooh, fighting games is something I really like, but I never got into them. I remember really enjoying Soul Calibur growing up. It wasn't Street Fighter... What was it? Oh my god. Well, Mortal Kombat, obviously, I played that for a bit. Because I had a family with three other brothers in it, so we used to play fighting games. Classic fighting games. Oh, I played all the Dragon Ball Z fighting games. They were brilliant. Smash Bros. Was fun. I played that on the Wii U. Tekken. Tekken was good. I liked a game for the PlayStation 1 called Thrill Kill. I think that was it for fighting games for me. One of the Mortal Kombats had a really cool story mode, though, and it had like a crypt where you could use currency to... It was like art, like random. You picked a crypt that cost money and you unlocked like at random. Well, you unlocked that crypt and it was, you didn't know what was in there. I have not played Yakuza. I have a friend who absolutely loves Yakuza, and I've seen YouTubers make funny videos on Yakuza, but I've never played it myself. And I think I regret it. It looks really good, like funny. I don't know if it looks necessarily good. It just looks very funny. What's causing that effect? Was that just it hitting that? If that's the case, why is this one not doing it? Whatever. I'm going to set all of these now. Do this. Oh, did I not duplicate? Whoops. Duplicate, there you go. Now do this. Now, oh no, really? Why is it, what? Why does it fit? That one needs to be the other way around. That's very strange. Look at all fine down here. Cool. Right, I'm gonna set the ceilings. If I turn off back faces, I'm out there, actually. There you go. Wait, so is there two floors? Hold on a minute. Did I just not select that floor? There is a second floor. It's just got the wrong... There you go. Cool. Basement will leave blank. Oh, no, we won't leave a blank roof, though, will we? No, we don't need a blank roof. We could put a roof on. I'm making them separate. Well, I have to UV map them as well. But I'm making them separate because when I go to texture them, it means I could just throw on some tiling textures, which should be... very quick and easy. Wait, did I not put a wall in there? Wow, I'm slacking. I got the things for it, I just don't have a wall in there. Yeah. There you go. I'm using Godot right now, just made a little movement system. Oh, that was fast. What did that hurt my shoulder? Pain. Metal Gear. Cool. Select all the walls again. Very smart unwrap. And select the floors. Select the ceiling quick over here and invert it. There you go. Select the floors. Cool. Turn off that. Select the ceilings. Cool. File, export, FBX. I'm just going to call that random ceilings. Export. It's a char. Random ceilings, and I don't want to merge them. The reason for that is so they're separate. So that's there to there. If we take this and copy its positioning, drag all those in, I should be able to then, there they are, assign their positioning to that location, and they should just squeeze in. They did, but I forgot to import the new walls. But we're blocking out some of the... What is going on? Oh, so yeah. Like Oh, it's because it's not two-sided as well, right? So if we look at the roof in here. Throw you on the ceilings. Is the ceiling in here actually that color? Cool, this will help block out some of the lights. As you can see, which it should, it's actually turned black like it is, which is perfect. Cool. I need to do the walls again. Oh, what I should have done is I should have unwrapped these as well for doing that. So let me quickly select them all. Well, I can't bother for now. I'll do it later. Because I'm a lazy boy. Walls. Back into here. Jesus Christ, select the walls. Where am I? I'm in Flanders house. Well, he's cube anyway. Reimport. Cool. And we should have those walls in now. Again, it'd be pitch black in here because we've got no windows at the moment, which is fine. We'll have them at some point. We'll have these bleeding effects, which I'm not sure get fixed on cinematic. No, they don't. So the way I tend to do that is I start using just some blocks, whatever, to help block out some of the roof. We're going to be making a second story at some point anyway, but for now, like that. And we have this very dark interior. If we obviously grab a light, we can start looking what it looks like. Looking what it looks like. It's a weird way to say that. There you go. Oh, so I've missed some bits here. That's supposed to be open for now. Tangling my foot up in wires again. So what part is that? Let's isolate this right here. Okay. It's fine. I'm never too fast as long as the problem can be resolved pretty quickly. I'm going to end the stream after I export this out. So that should be the last one. Cool. File, export. The next will be making windows and all of them. Oh, I didn't. Oh, what the heck? Whoa, why did it get really bright for a second? Oh, I haven't done these walls either? I swear I did. Oh, I missed just that one. Silly Billy. All right, I needed to unwrap it anyway. That I forgot to do. Oops. Smart project. Hi, Steve. Oh, Nabo, I'm literally just about to leave, man. How's it going? I'm just making, setting up. Okay, lighting, can you resort yourself back out? Nice. I'm just setting up, sort of the building at the moment, so we have the rest of the rooms. Oh, you know what? I want to make this room as well quickly. Although, not the room, but I want to make the door. I'll keep noticing things. So that way we have the entire bottom floor. And I really, really wanted to get that done today. Sort of a progression thing, you know. If you can set a task that you want to get done for the day and you get it done, you're going to feel much better when you get to bed. And I want to go to bed tonight. Trust me. I am a tired boy. Why is it like... No, this guy's really transparent. I guess it's because you've got the white floor, so it just makes it look pretty transparent. Oh, so the door's like here. And I assume it's like one of the curved tops, so one of the curved tops. So let's look at it straight down. Let's make a edge loop for them. One here, one, align that one here, and align that one here. Delete that. Oh, I didn't need to delete the top one. Oopsies. There you go. Now, the problem is, like I said, these ones are actually a bit taller. So I should bring this up to the tippy top of that one. Cool, that's good. Boom, boom. 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 Because these ones are archways, so they're essentially bigger doors from what I'm aware. Why is that not beveling? I missed that. There you go. There you go. Oh, I also... Oh, whoops. That is a render mode. I've clearly made a mistake here. And here, because I assume there's an extra edge loop over here. So let's align that up. There you go. Hold on a minute. Just flatten it. Oh, right. I was going to say, why is it so weird? It's fine. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, my. Yeah. Select you, select you, and make a curve. It's fine. Cool. We've got this nice little curve thing. Yeah. This. Gonna make this an N-gon. I just like using it as an N-gon. Yeah. Better to divide by room. Every room is separate object that make work easier to model. Yeah, I was thinking that when I did it. Obviously, when I first did it, I rushed it. So I just made it all one big layout. I did see someone model it like this. So I just kind of did what they did. But I think that would have been an easier way to do it. Because like, when I was watching someone do it, they basically did it this way. And then they just separate each room out to the own materials. So they'd select all the walls around here into their own materials. The only annoyance doing it the other way, which probably would be easier anyway, is you've got these door frames that connect up, whereas usually you have an actual door frame that helps separate out the part of the building, you know what I mean? Like, because I've done it before that way anyway, but like, you'd usually have some sort of framing on it. It's kind of like how the windows are, right? I could just show you that. Yeah, kind of like the windows, which means you can actually just delete these parts. And it means you could just have it as a completely separate component. I probably should have done it that way. But maybe I'll do it that way eventually. Off stream, though. Definitely off stream. On stream, I think that'd be a bit awkward. That should be working now. Well, export. So for now, we'll just do it like this. And maybe I'll change it off stream. I probably will change it off stream. Should be a door that appears. Nice. Cool lighting fix itself. Cool. Now we can pass through into here. I need to make a window here that looks like this window. Well, from the inside anyway. I need to make this look better anyway. This room's kind of naff. This room's definitely... The shadows load. Definitely the focal point right now. But yeah, so we've got... Obviously, it's back. Look at that origin point. Cool. I need a table in here and everything. And I actually need to make this look good. It's not a very nice cupboard because it was only a background asset when I made it. But yeah, we got all the doors. And I think I want that one shorter, but I'm not sure. Kitchen. Simpsons. There's got to be something that shows those doors, right? Apparently not. Aha, here you go. There is. Okay, so they've kept them the same level here, which is quite tall. Getting tired, I think I'm going to leave. See you next time. I'm going to leave soon as well, don't worry. Well, I don't know why you'd worry. So maybe I will align that, but I'll do that next stream. Yeah, because look how short that looks now. I might make this wider too. Because if you look here, again, I think this might be someone's recreation of it, but it's still a very good drawing. It's quite wide, so I might replicate that and make it quite wide. And then make this one taller. And there's actually a bit of the wall that sticks out here. Was that in the reference? Oh, it is. Bummer. I kind of want to fix that now as well. Oh, this wall won't work now, though, because of the way I've done it. Modeling interior is tedious task, but it makes the modeling learn a lot on it. Yeah, the modeler, sorry, learn a lot on it. Yeah, 100%. I've probably made every interior I've ever made, I've made a different way every time. Which I don't think is necessarily a bad thing, because at least you get to learn new ways of doing things. So I'm not against that. Can I make it go completely straight? Oh, apparently not. Let's isolate it. God, I just said I wanted to leave, but if I don't do this now, I'll forget. Oh, really? It won't let me... Oh. Well, that'd be why, won't it? There you go, have to leave. There you go. I gotta go there now. Gotta work on my scene. Have a good one, Steve. Have a good one, man. I hope you enjoyed the stream, and I'll hope to catch you some other time. Oh my god, it just got really laggy. Boom, boom. Well, it is laggy right now. Whoa. I don't know what I selected there. Oh, it's because I've selected everything in the scene. Jesus. Cool. Let's come down here. Let's see. Do this. Pull you down. Turn that on. Pull that in. Technically, I should probably align it with this, actually. From a designer perspective, why does it keep doing that? And grab this and pull this out. Delete the bottoms and tops. We have that little piece that comes out of the wall. Like that. Perfect. Do another smart unwrap because I'm lazy. Save. File. Export. FBX selected only. Wall. Into here. Reimport. Have a wall lighting, thank you. Which have a wall that comes out here. All the walls aren't the right textures now, but we'll fix that next stream. Nice. And then the fridge goes in here. Might have to collapse that back a bit to give us some room, but looking pretty good. Very dark in here. Like, I can't even see. Oh my god, it's like a horror movie or horror game, I guess. I love, like, shading like that, though. Don't you think that's cool? Just seeing that little bit of shadow come through. I think that's so sick. I know it's nothing special, but, like, just seeing lighting bounce in real time, and not even real time, even rendering. Seeing, like, lighting hit this and cause that effect, and, like, a little bit of the floor just looks really cool. All right. So next, we'll be looking at getting, well, probably aligning all of these up to meet this standard instead. Even the ones out here, getting the door frames done, getting the windows done. Yeah, I'll work on one project. Everybody have it starting on trouble. I have an idea, Steve, to create a modeling group and work on one project. Everybody have its task, and we try to practice some work team experience. Oh, what, like in the Discord, like make a project, and even if it's 10 of us, then we can get on and then we try to get something together. That's not a bad idea. I mean, if you can organize it. I don't have a lot of time to organize it, but if you guys can get it organized, I'll definitely do my part and make something. I think that'd be really cool. I assume that's what you meant. You're like, that's not what I meant at all, Steve. But I'd love to do that. Anyways, so what I'm going to do today, I think we made good progress, really. Like, it's just getting all this to flow and work as one environment now, and then possibly start working on making the second floor work as well. So come up and you get all the rooms here. That'd be really fun. I can't wait to get all that working. And if all that goes well, we can start making the exterior. Only the blocking it. Well, blocking out. This isn't really blocking out. This is sort of the basic modeling stage to get things actually working. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. And yeah, like a Discord. Yeah, I think that'd be a brilliant idea if we can get it together. If you're not part of the Discord, I'm pretty sure you are, right? But if you're not part of it, the Discord link's below. But yeah. I can't remember saying, but that's the end of the stream. And hopefully I'll catch you guys tomorrow. I am at the hospital. And I don't know how long I'm going to be there for. If I'm there too long, I will try to connect to somebody's Wi-Fi because I don't have any data at the moment. And I will try to send a message on the Discord say I'm not going to be streaming. But hopefully I'll be back on time. Hopefully I can stream. So I will catch you guys then. Bye-bye.